Now live over Zoom is Dale Lee, the president of the West Virginia Education Association. Mr. Lee, thank you for joining me tonight.
Thank you for having me.
Explain to the viewers, how did nearly 100 cases of COVID on WVU's campus become just one overnight?
It was determined earlier that the cases in our prisons and our nursing homes be counted as one. And I understand that because they're in isolation. The prisoners can't go out in the community, nor do those in the nursing homes. But this is different because the students are still allowed, even though they're housed in one dorm, they're still allowed to come and go in the community. All they have to do is use their swipe card to know when they come back into the dorm. So we believe that this is the wrong way to do this, and counting them as one just really skews the numbers.
What is the argument that they make for counting the cases in congregate housing, like the schools or the nursing homes you mentioned, as just one case?
Well, because it's not the community spread. And in prison and nursing home situation, although the workers are in the community and spread it, the actual patients and the prisoners are not. But again, this is different because the students can come and go freely.
Down there near campus, are you seeing the COVID cases that are happening on campus spread out into the county and to other counties?
I think you will see it even more as they go back into live situation or face-to-face situation. You will see the spread of this. And the WVEA has consistently said you have to err on the side of caution. You shouldn't put educators and students' health at risk.
With this change, who do you think is going to benefit from it?
I don't know that anyone's going to benefit from it, but the parents and students who have been pressing to have athletics and to have in-person instruction are the ones that supposedly are going to benefit. But if this thing spreads, then no one really benefits.
Do you know of any other states that are going to follow suit or doing the same thing?
Not to my knowledge. I know Kentucky has a map similar to West Virginia, but they're just starting there. So we're going to have to wait and see what they do as far as, I call it manipulating the numbers, because that's exactly what we're doing with this.
Well, Dale Lee, thank you for taking the time for us tonight, and best of luck this school year. We'll have to wait and see what happens.
Well, thank you for having me.